Hello everybody, welcome to our video tutorials. In this video, we will give you an overview about the InterconnectMapper software for exchanging data in between Woodward power management controllers. We have been always taking care about a maximum flexibility on our controls to ensure that we are able to match most of customers' requirements in their application. Also, the exchange of data in between the single units has been covered by RPDOs and TPDOs via CAN bus. In the meanwhile, the applications and controllers have become more complex, and for sure, they are providing a lot more of data on the interfaces. To cover this information flood, we are introducing the InterconnectMapper software, which enables the user to exchange binary and analog data and measurements in between the participants via Ethernet interface. The installing file can be downloaded from the Woodward homepage. After downloading, just follow the installation routine. This is the main menu screen of the InterconnectMapper. For more detailed information about the single screens, please check out the Help section. To create a new project, select New Project from the Files menu. To add devices, click on the plus. You now will be prompted to upload a package.zip file. This is the same package file that other tools such as Modbus Master Mapper, Data Telegram Mapper, etc. use. The installation files can be downloaded here. After uploading the package files, the available devices are shown on the left-hand menu. To add them to the Members section, you need to click on the plus there. A drop-down menu is opened, and you can choose the device you want to add. The package files can be added several times to match the number of needed devices. In the Members section, you can define the device ID, the cycle time, the access type, which toggles different access types to real devices or simulation. In the Access section, you can define the IP address, the login, and the password. Now, we can switch to the mapping area. In this section, we need to define the sending and the receiving data and addresses. Let's start with the sender and define the data which should be sent to the other members. We need to set the byte address, the data type, etc., and also the value which should be sent. After we have set all the required values, we can add the settings via the Add button to the sender list. Now, we will switch to the receiver section. In the first setup, there will be only one block ID, so we first need to add a second block ID via the plus button to be able to add the receive block from the LS612XT. You can easily add the send data to the receive section via drag and drop. The software is indicating two problems with the configuration. We need to adjust the receive ID and the timeout. When all settings are correct, the failure indication disappears. After you have defined a directory where the mapping should be stored, the mapping files will be created. You will find two mapping files in the destination folder. The files are marked as file type SCP. These files then can be loaded to the devices with toolkit software via load application function. After loading the files to the devices, we can check in the interfaces menu if there are any error codes or timeouts detected. To get the mapping to work, we need to define the interface which should be used for the communication. This parameter need to be set to the same value in both units and can be set up in the Configure Interfaces menu. In our example, we want to have the mains, phase/phase voltage, available in the analog manager of the EasyGen. For this, the EasyGen XT is reading out analog value 01.55 of the LS6XT, which is connected to the mains on system A. To show you the result of the mapping we created, I'm using the SimuBox. Here, a screenshot of the used application model. The entered mains values are 407 volts and 50 hertz. We will work with LS6, ID33, and EasyGen of Generator 1. I chose internal value 5 in the LS6 to send the system A phase/phase voltage to the EasyGen. Below the equation, you can see the analog manager result, parameter 9658. Which shows you the live value of the analog manager. Here you can see the receiver view. In the EasyGen, I used also internal value 5 to receive the measured value of the LS6 device. Also here, the live value is shown below the analog manager at parameter 9658. To be able to create mapping files, the software needs to be licensed. The licensing procedure is the same as we are doing in our other tools. This is all for today. Make sure you check our other video tutorials.